Welcome back to another edition of Fly Tying for Beginners. Today we're going to tie a bicolor grizzly dry fly. The hook that I have in the vise is a Maruto. This is a D4. This is a size 16. And this is a barbless dry fly hook from frostyfly.com. I'm going to use tan thread, and this is 70 denier. We're going to get a base of thread down, starting back at that eye. And this is a lot like a Griffith's Gnat, but we're going to have a little bit different colors in there. Griffith's Gnat is one of the best flies ever designed. There's a little variation of that. We're going to start out, we're going to put on a tail there.
And for the tail, I'm going to use a couple of ginger hackle.
And I want that tail to be about the length of the hook shank. We'll go ahead and tie that in. And we'll trim that off. First, I'm going to start with a natural grizzly. And you can see I have the crew cut on there. Just stand those barbels up at 90 degrees and trim them off close. And this gives the thread something to hold to. And we want to leave just a couple of those barbs exposed. Let me back that off. Leave just a couple of those barbs exposed so that when we start wrapping, our first wraps won't send the barbels from the hackle towards the back. And we're going to secure that and bring that thread back. Now I'm going to take just a small pinch of beaver dubbing. This is natural beaver, and we're just going to get a little bit on there. And we're going to take that and wind that forward. You can leave that pretty shaggy. And we'll stop that there, about an eye length from the eye of the hook. Now we're going to take that our hackle, get one whole wrap at the back there, and then we're going to palmer that forward. Three wraps is plenty, and then we're going to tie that down. I'm going to hold that back and put a couple of wraps right in front of it. And then we can remove that excess. Get that nice palmered effect there. Now I'm going to take a grizzly brown. And I have that little crew cut on there. And we're going to tie that in right in front of that natural. And then we're going to wrap this, and we're going to wrap this a tight wrap. Give it that appearance of a little bit darker on the front. Then I'm going to tie that down. This saddle hackle, you can see how long this is. They're really nice for dry flies. They're more expensive, but they're really nice. Go ahead and trim that excess.
I got a couple of hackles pointing out front. I'm going to use my half-inch tool. Push them back. There we go. Push them right back out of that way. And then we're going to build our head. Take our whip finish. Put just a little bit of head cement on there. Clean that brush off well. And I'm going to run a feather through there, through the eye, just to be sure that we're clear. Using these Griffith's gnat type flies, especially when you're just starting out fly fishing, these are easy to make. You could learn a technique of wrapping the hackle, and these are very good flies. This will catch fish when a lot of other flies won't. Hope that you learned something from this video. Hope that you would subscribe to my channel. Please refer me to your friends. Leave comments, questions, suggestions. Please visit my sponsor. And most of all, thank you very much for watching my videos.